And he's done it.
Ta-da! Woohoo! Kathy and I have made it to Amsterdam.
Yay!
Whoop whoop. So, Amsterdam, you are absolutely killing us at the moment. 34 degrees today.
I reckon it was hotter.
So hot.
Yeah.
Probably feels hotter.
And that train.
Europe is going through the middle of a heat wave. I think, like, after about 4 or 5 days, it's supposed to drop by about 10, almost 10 degrees. I think about 7, 8 degrees. So, it's, yeah, quite a big difference. And on the train, oh my gosh, there's so many people. So we're absolutely dying. So I don't think there's many people, there's many places to eat. That might be the lucky late thing. I'm gonna have to resume this later. Bye. Sorry about that earlier. So, I probably gotta speak a little bit more quietly. We have made it to the campground, but the walls aren't very big, so.
And it is like 11 o'clock.
Yeah. So we're just going to talk a little bit more quietly. But for you guys, I'll bump up the audio, so maybe it's not too bad. Anyway. So yeah, we've made it to the campground. Sorry I had to pause earlier. The van ended up coming and we had to jump in it. We had to take the train. Once we arrived in Amsterdam, we had to catch a train to a certain train stop and then catch the place that we're at offers free shuttle services to and from the campsite. Yeah, because it is a little bit further out from Amsterdam, because Amsterdam is super expensive. And then once we're here, it was so hot, unbearably hot, and we found out that there was a lake,
which is funny,
that's here. Didn't do our research too well. We're at this place called Lucky Lakes. Yeah, so we booked this place but didn't even realize that it had a lake. Which I guess makes sense since this place is called Lucky Lakes. Anyway, there's a lake there. Well, there is a lake here, and when we found that out, we pretty much dropped all our stuff and then ran to the lake and then jumped in. It was so refreshing. Being a lake, it's fresh water as well, so it was so nice. So yeah, so we're there for quite a while and then so now here we are. We just got something to eat, and this place is so cool. Can't wait to show you guys this in the morning. They're in little like camper vans. Would you call it like that? Like caravans. Little like caravans. And they're all like kind of decked out in like different colors and lights and stuff. So that's yeah, it's quite cool. So I'll show you guys that in the morning. But for now, we're just making the bed and stuff.
And Jordan needs to go because right now he's talking to you guys instead of helping me with my duvet.
I'm doing something very important right now. So yeah, so that is the plan. Tomorrow we're going to head into Amsterdam town. Show you guys around there.
Into the city.
Into the city. So we're off. And we will catch you guys tomorrow. Yeah, so it's the next morning here. Cassie and I are running a little bit late again for the van.
No.
But these cool little camper van? Caravan. Oh, things are so cool. So yeah, so we're just gonna go into the main town now. So we just caught the train into the central station, which is here. And we're just gonna literally just go for a wander and see what we can find. Probably head to the red light district at some point. And that's Cathy after she's woken up
from a nap on the train.
So just as an update, it is still boiling. And I feel like it's not as hot. Still maybe about 32 degrees. Anyway, at the moment, we're just walking through the market. We just had a quick coffee stop before, walking into a few interesting shops. So we checked out the, what's it called? The condomery, I think it was. So like novelty condoms and stuff, which was really interesting. and we checked out just a few other interesting stores, and now we're just walking through the markets and just seeing what there is. I think it's probably gonna have to go stop for some food soon because I'm getting quite hungry. And yeah, we'll see what else is in the district here.
Gonna find somewhere to sit?
Yum.
It's got ragu, herbs and spices, and a little bit of beef.
Yum.
The duck store.
The Amsterdam duck store. So many
Potter,
of them.
Jack Sparrow. Look. Ariana Grande.
Ducks on ducks on ducks on ducks. Yeah, so Cassie and I have just arrived back at the campsite, and it is still super hot, so we decided to go for a little swim. So we got some stuff with us here. Cassie's got some juice, I've got some lollies, and we're just gonna go for a little bit of a dip, cool off,
yeah,
and go for a swim. Today's been really good, although we're kind of just like aimlessly walking around lots, so yeah. We ended up, and because it was so hot, we had to stop like every 200 meters, go into a shop, just so we could be in the AC in the store. And we ended up spending so much money just because we needed to like go into places and then drink and then eat and yeah. Ooh. Anyway, we're gonna go for a dip. So yeah, I guess this is the lake, by the way, if you do want to see it, because I got my GoPro with me, so I'm sure I'll show some footage. So this is the lake. It's a new day. Cassie is a lot more awake today than she was on the train yesterday.
I was so tired actually.
Flashbacks to yesterday on the train. Can't Zoom zoom, we're going to be catching that next couple of days to get to the airport. Anyway, yeah, we will be. Anyway, we're waiting here for our train to take us into town. It's about 3 o'clock, and we're going to be taking a free walking tour. Same company that we went on, the one in Berlin, which was awesome, would highly recommend. So we'll let you guys know how this one goes. And then after that, I think we might go check out some more things along the red light district, see how that changes from daytime to nighttime, and also get something to eat, very important. So we might try some more Dutch food if we can and go from that point. So that's the plan today, so hopefully it's a good one. There is the narrowest house in Amsterdam, is that
one,
right?
one of the
And it is, yeah, it's pretty narrow. So looking at those guys that are just walking through there at the moment, that gives you a little bit of scale into like how narrow it is. Anyway, we've just finished our walking tour, and it was great. Would highly recommend again. Just so much knowledge that I managed to pack down in such a short amount of time. So we kind of walked around. Yesterday we were pretty much just spending it all in the red light district, but this time on the walking tour it was kind of everywhere else around the other side of Amsterdam, not the red light district. So that was really cool to see, get some good knowledge and just history around Amsterdam in general and the Netherlands, and yeah, so it was really good.
And while Jordan's been telling you all that, you've just been watching me scoff down.
Yeah, my camera strap is just very difficult to try and turn this around and look at me, so you just get a face full of gas, you're just eating their churros. Anyway, I'm gonna enjoy my churros now because I got some. Yummy chocolate
pretzels.
Although a little bit dear, $7.50 for both of us, so
that's okay. In total.
much is that? Like 12 New Zealand dollars roughly.
That's not too bad.
Okay. Time to enjoy this. Yum yum. Bye. Checking out our lucky legs. So today, Cassie and I checking out our lucky legs. But we're still staying in Amsterdam. We're just gonna go stay with a mate for a couple of days until our flight back to London. So from here on in, we are going to the van, catching the train, and then heading to Mac's apartment. On the road again. This is Cassie putting her bag on. Made that look really easy. I'm gonna use this. Okay. Oh shit, I dropped it.
Run.
We have just gone and seen Mac and dumped our stuff off at the apartment and just caught up over a. Sorry, it's like dodging these little bits here. Yeah, so we caught up for a coffee, that was really cool. And
real cool place to be somewhere.
Yeah, so that was really cool, and just catching up on a whole lot of stuff, that was awesome. So now we're heading to go and see Anne Frank, because we managed to get tickets yesterday.
Last night I refreshed the page, and because like they've got the 80-20 rule, so like 2 months in advance they release 80% of the tickets, which have already sold out like 2 months ago. But then on the day, or like I suppose the day before as well, they released the last 20% of the tickets. And I refreshed it last night and got tickets for 4:30 today. Booyah!
Booyah! Sorry.
And I've been like literally trying for that since we've been away.
Another little tip is that they release the tickets throughout the day when they release those last 20%. So
I was just like, I'll just check.
You just gotta check throughout the day. Apparently one of the most common times are around midday for the tickets to come out. So a little top tip there for you. So Anne Frank's, we're heading there. House, we're heading there, but it's got 2 hours until we can go in, because that's when our tickets are booked. So until then, we're just going to walk around. I think we're heading into the district called Jordan, I think it is. It's like my name, but with like 2 A's instead of 1. So we're heading there and just going to walk around. Apparently it's got some nice canals, so might get some nice canal shots. That is a couch. Just floating in the canal.
Come on,
they're gonna hit the couch, they're gonna hit the couch, they're gonna hit the couch. Oh no, oh yeah, they hit it. Fact of the day. Why do the buildings in Amsterdam lean out?
This. That's
yeah, exactly.
Top.
You can't really see it
why,
here at the moment.
But,
oh, right.
Can't they?
It's because.
And why are there hooks at the top?
It's because Amsterdam is charged on the width of the houses, so they have very narrow houses, and so it was very difficult for people to get stuff up to the top. So they actually, back in the day, used to build the buildings with a slight leaning out into the street, so they could then carry stuff up.
No, but you don't. That doesn't make sense.
It does.
So when they, well, then
oh,
why
sorry.
Though? Yeah.
Because when they lifted stuff up, it would then swing in the wind, and it would break the windows. And then they put a lean onto the building, so there's more swingage room without it smashing into the windows.
But then when they got really smart, instead of just having it like hang like right next to the window, they like built it out, so then it was like out further, so it didn't hit the window anyway.
So like how there's like hooks up there at the moment.
Fun fact, back to the day.
Back to the day. Also, Okay, double fact of the day. Double fact of the day. How many bikes are taken out of the canals each year? Go on, Cassie.
2,000.
2,000? Each year. Or is it 20,000?
No, 2,000 out of the lake, and then there's more bikes.
Canals.
River, canals. And then there's more bikes than humans in Amsterdam.
Hmm. Lots of facts there for you from Cassie.
And they say that the canals are 3 meters deep, but really that's only really 1 meter of pocket water. It's got a meter of mud, a meter of bikes, and then a meter of water at the top.
I think it's just a saying.
No, it's a fact. We're standing outside Anne Frank's house.
So there's a sign right there, which is literally right outside Anne Frank's house, and it's literally right up there where she stays.
We're in the secret annex, and it's kind of on the other side.
Yeah, so it's a bit hard to see. So we're just gonna go into the museum now and go check it out.
Yeah, so we can actually video in there. But it is hands down one of the best museums we have ever been into. Only cost 10 euro as well, so it's pretty good. And they just have guided audio tours throughout the whole thing.
Which is free and you just like listen.
Yeah, as well as like posters and stuff like that. So, and lots of original documents and photos and videos.
No, the shop's closing and I wanted to buy something, sorry. And Frank, thanks. I just really wanted to buy a tote bag from this place and it's closing.
Well, hurry up and go run and get it. Go on.
Maybe I'll go tomorrow. But you have to take me here tomorrow. I feel like everything we're going is in the opposite direction.
Good morning. So it's a new day here in Amsterdam. Last night was awesome. We went back to Max's apartment after we went and checked out Anne Frank's. And then we just had drinks, dinner. It was just really good catching up. What else do we do? And then pretty much now it's just a new day. We are now going to go check out the I Amsterdam sign. We got up fairly early, not super early, it's about... it'll be just before 9 when we get there. So we'll see how busy it is. And then we try and cross the road. Don't even go on the bike. Gotta look left, look right. Look left, look right. Go. You want to come and you want no one else to be here?
Be here earlier than 9.
Yeah, come here earlier than 9 o'clock. I mean, there's not a huge amount of people, but there are other people on here.
There's no one in the D, should I go right now?
Go, run, 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 run. Alrighty, Cassie, so we just come back from checking out the I Amsterdam sign, and what we stumbled across?
A little market.
Because did you really go to the airport if you didn't get Macca's?
Not even proper Macca's breakfast though. It's no BLT. No hot chocolate, no hash browns.
Exactly. So the fact that Cassie's having Macca's and we're at an airport means that it is our last morning in Amsterdam. And
last
we're heading back
day.
To London. So just to recap yesterday, we're actually real tired in the middle of the day, so after our market trip we pretty much just like we packed and then we slept.
We had to get one bag less.
Yeah, because we weren't sure if EasyJet would let us take like a sling-on bag and count it as two carry-ons. So yeah, we packed, slept, and then
chilled with Matt for the rest of the day, really.
Went to that incredible vegan burger place.
Oh yes, the vegan place was amazing. That's I didn't bring my camera really with me, but I wish I did. It was really good. And I'm a big meat eater. So the vegan place was real good. I'll drop it somewhere in this video.
Vegan junk food.
What it's called. Okay, well, Cassie just talked.
What, Cassie?
So, now we're heading back to London. 3 months of travel. So now we're starting to get our lives sorted. It has been an incredible adventure. It makes me kind of sad.
Yeah.
Just reflecting on it now. 3 months of adventure. It has been crazy, different. In different environments, different
fun, exhausting. Yeah,
it's been a crazy, crazy adventure.
A whole lot of trying to speak a whole lot of language or a whole lot of yes, yes. A whole lot of trying new things, new foods, seeing new places.
Caved a few times, I got Macca's and Subway. But, you know, it was incredible.
If I sound real tired, that's because our flight is at 8. We had to get up at like 10 to 5 this morning to get to the airport on time. Yeah, we had 4 hours sleep, so that's the reason why. I guess this is a goodbye. This is the end of our 3 month adventure, so.
Until next time.
Until next time. Until the next adventure. Cassie and Jordan. A bit too early, man.
Yeah, Cassie and Jordan, over and out.